bebopping at Brush Creek. An old blue sock hanging from a tree. Broken glass conspicuous in the water. A razor without a blade, tattered and ucky. I saw a half-filled bottle of cheap beer. Wex found a century-old bottle which once held a healing elixir. All were interesting, but none belonged. There was a crayfish, crawdad, or crawfish, depending on your perspective. He was at home, and he did belong. The larva, aquatic worm, snail, clams, and red-tailed maggot found might not bode well for the health of the water. It was cold, quick-moving, and filmy, but it had a sense of uniqueness. Brush Creek made our day. Our cry to it should be to good health and roll on, thrive into the future until we see you again.
Watershed from local stream.
How do you feel about the temperature?
It's cold.
And the volume and the speed?
The speed is a little bit quick. There's a little bit of a current.
Okay. What about when you put your hand in the water?
Very cold.
And the speed and volume?
I do think that the current is quick, like it is really quick. I didn't think it was at first.
Okay, now put your hand on the very bottom. And how does it compare there?
It feels calmer at the bottom.
What about the temperature?
It's cold.
The coldest at the bottom?
Yeah, it is.
Top of the water?
Okay, on the top of the water.
Yeah. And how do you feel? Like the temperature, when it comes to the temperature and the volume, maybe the speed?
The temperature is a lot colder than maybe the air temperature. We're on a downhill slope, so the force is a little greater than it is upstream there where it's flatter.
Okay. All right. Now, if you'll put your hand in the water. Not all the way to the bottom, just in it. And now what do you think? How does it compare to the temperature of the top of the water?
It's slimier underwater.
Slimier? Yeah.
There's a current rushing along the bottom. It's a little swifter than the top.
All right, now what about at the very bottom? Put your hand on the very bottom.
No real change between the middle and the bottom.